Hi friends, welcome you all. In the last lecture, we have discussed the different models of bank assurance. Today in this lecture, we are going to discuss the RBI guidelines for the banks to enter into insurance business. So we are going to discuss it into two parts. Today I have planned to discuss part first, and in the next lecture we are going to discuss the second part of RBI guidelines for the banks to enter into insurance business or do business activity in the bank assurance. So friends, the RBI guidelines given in the circular of RBI 9th August 2000 circular is available on the Reserve Bank of India's website, and the Department of Banking Operations and Development Center First in the Mumbai have issued these circular, and overall Reserve Bank of India issued this circular for the banks and given some guidelines and eligibility criteria for banks to enter into insurance business. So what are these guidelines? Let us discuss one by one. Very first guideline is any scheduled commercial bank. Only schedule means those banks who have listed in the second schedule of the Reserve Bank of India Act 1934. So scheduled banks are listed in the second schedule of Reserve Bank of India Act 1934. So any scheduled commercial bank would be permitted to undertake insurance business as agent of insurance companies on fee basis without any risk participation. The subsidiaries of banks will also be allowed to undertake distribution of insurance product on agency basis. So here one word is important, that is risk participation. So there are two categories for banks where they can enter into insurance business. First category is risk participation, and another one is risk participation, and one is without risk participation. So for without risk participation, the scheduled commercial banks allowed to undertake insurance business as agent of insurance company on fee basis. So this is the without risk participation. And subsidiaries of banks also allowed it to undertake distribution of insurance product on agency basis. Number second guideline is banks which satisfy the eligibility criteria given below will be permitted to set up a joint venture company for undertaking insurance business with risk participation. So if bank want to enter into insurance business like in the form of joint venture, then it is called risk participation. So here the insurance business risk is also on the bank. In case of above guideline number first guideline, there bank is acting as agent only, not participating fully like a insurance company. So in the second case, in the risk participation, bank can form a joint venture and can undertake the insurance business with risk participation subject to safeguard. So Reserve Bank of India given some safeguards, the banks have to follow that. The maximum equity contribution such as bank can hold in the joint venture company will normally be 50% of the paid up capital of the insurance company. So where joint venture is there, means insurance company and bank coming together and forming a joint venture company, the maximum limit of shareholding of bank is 50% of the paid up capital. Means paid up capital means actually subscribed capital by the people. On a selective basis, the Reserve Bank of India may permit a higher equity contribution by a promoter bank initially, pending disinvestment of equity within the prescribed period. So bank can allowed Reserve Bank of India can allowed to bank to hold the higher equity than 50%, but initially it is only for initially. Later on, and it is the category where pending disinvestment shown, means if bank holds 60% shares, then 50% is normally permitted, and 10% shareholding are pending disinvestment, means bank have to later on sell it to the insurance company or to the public. So promoters bank initially can hold more than 50% shares, but later on it has to disinvest or it has to sell and decrease the shareholding pattern, shareholding to the 50%. Holding of equity by a promoter bank in an insurance company or participation in any form in insurance business will be subject to compliance with rules and regulations laid by the IRDA and central government. What is the meaning of this statement? The statement says that the equity holding pattern of the promoter bank, promoter means those who start business actually, should be under the rules or subject to the compliance and any rules, regulations given by the Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India, that is IRDAI, and central government from time to time. So rules and regulations also, bank also should follow these rules which are set by IRDAI and central government in case of bank assurance. This will include compliance with Section 6AA of the Insurance Act as amended by the IRDA Act 1999. So the compliance and rules given in the Section 6AA of the Insurance Act as amended by the IRDA Act 1999 for disinvestment of equity in excess of 26% of the paid up capital within a prescribed period of time. Next guideline is the eligibility criteria given here for joint venture participation. Suppose a particular bank wants to form a joint venture with insurance company. What are the eligibility criteria for bank is given here according to the March 31st, 2000. First is the net worth of the bank should not be less than 500 crores. So net worth of the bank should not be, means it should not be very small bank. The net worth minimum on the March 31st, 2000 should be 500 or more. Second eligibility criteria is the CRAR. Means the capital adequate ratio of the bank should not be less than 10%. So what is the CRAR or CAR? it is the limit of NPA or it is the risk to asset weighted ratio. It is in simple words we can say that in a simple word it is capital risk weighted asset ratio or capital adequacy ratio. What is capital adequacy ratio? It is given by the Bank for International Settlement, that is BIS, and Basel norms. So BIS formed Basel norms, and according to Basel norms, the capital adequacy ratio should be 8%. And here the eligibility criteria for banks to form a joint venture for insurance, the CRAR of the bank should not be less than 10%. The level of non-performing assets should be reasonable. So non-performing assets means the loss asset, the loans given by banks not came back, so it is we can call non-performing assets. So the level of non-performing asset should be reasonable. The bank should have net profit for the last 3 continuous years. The bank should have net profit in the continuous last 3 years, not in a loss. And last eligibility criteria is the track record of the performance of the subsidiaries, if any, of the concerned bank should be satisfactory. So the performance of subsidiaries also considered here. The track record of the performance of subsidiaries of that bank should also be satisfactory. So these are the eligibility criteria to form the joint venture with the insurance companies. Next guideline is, in cases where a foreign partner contributes 26% of the equity with the approval of Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India, Foreign Investment Promotion Board, more than one public sector bank or private sector bank may be allowed to participate in the equity of the insurance joint venture. So the where foreign partner of joint venture contributing 26% with the approval of Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority and Foreign Investment Board, more than one public sector bank or private sector bank may be allowed to participate in the equity of the insurance joint venture. Means in that case, more than one public sector private sector bank allowed to participate in the joint venture. As such, participants will also assume insurance risk. Only those banks which satisfy the criteria given in paragraph 2 above would be eligible. A subsidiary of bank or of another bank will not normally be allowed to join the insurance company on risk participation basis. A subsidiary of bank, suppose the small company of any bank which is formed is not normally allowed to join insurance company on the risk participation basis. It can work as an agent, not form a joint venture. Subsidiaries would include bank subsidiaries undertaking merchant banking, securities, mutual fund, leasing finance and housing finance business, etc. Subsidiaries, which subsidiaries include which are normally not allowed to join the insurance company on risk participation basis are merchant banking, securities, mutual fund, leasing finance, housing finance business, etc. For example, SBI Mutual Fund is the subsidiaries of State Bank of India, like that. So next guideline is fifth guideline. Banks which are not eligible as joint venture participation as above can make investment up to 10% of the net worth of the bank or 50 crore, which is whichever is lower. Means if banks are not eligible to form a joint venture, they can also participate or make investment up to 10% of net worth of bank or 50 crores, whichever lower, in the insurance company for providing infrastructure and services support. So 10% at least the bank can participate in insurance, but the bank can initially make investment in the infrastructure and service support which is not eligible to form joint venture. Such participation shall be treated as investment and should be without any contingent liability for the bank. So it is not a liability of bank, it is a investment of bank. The eligibility criteria for these banks will be as under the CRAR, that is capital risk asset ratio of the bank should not be less than 10%. The level of NPAs, that is non-performing asset, should be reasonable. The bank should have net profit for the last 3 continuous years. So these small banks which are not eligible to participate in joint ventures have to follow these criteria. The bank should have net profit for the last 3 continuous years. Next guideline is all banks entering into insurance business will be required to obtain prior approval of the Reserve Bank. So banks, those who want to enter into insurance business, they have to take permission of Reserve Bank of India. The Reserve Bank will give permission to banks on case-to-case basis, keeping in view all relevant factors including the position in regard to the level of non-performing assets of the applicant bank, so as to ensure that non-performing assets do not pose any future threat to the bank in its present or the proposed line of activity. So why Reserve Bank of India is giving permission or provides permission to bank on the case to case basis? Because Reserve Bank of India study all relevant factors including the position in regard of the non-performing assets of the applicant bank and all other factors, and ensure that the bank should not pose any future threat to the bank in its present proposed line of activity into insurance business. So insurance business, because of the insurance business, the bank's main business should not be hampered, or the bad effect of the insurance business should not be on the banking business. Reserve Bank of India take care of that and allowed only such banks that have the lower NPAs and all other factors satisfactory. It should be ensured that risk involved in insurance business do not get transferred to the bank, and that the banking business does not get contaminated by any risk which may arise from insurance business. So in a simple words, we can say that the bank should not be get any risk, or the banking main business should not be hampered by the insurance business or anything which is badly affect the banking business, which should not be arise in future. The factors which are which can create the threat to banking business from insurance business, Reserve Bank of India do not give the permission to such banks. So there should be arm length relationship between the bank and insurance company or outfit. What is arm length? Means the intimacy. Intimacy means the banking business and insurance business two are the separate business, and it should consider the banking business separate from the insurance business. So these are the two different businesses should be treated, and bank should be arm length relationship between bank and insurance outfit. And next guidelines, actually these are the notes means the according to the above guidelines, these are the rule setup or notes extra addition to the above guideline. Audited balance sheet for the year ended March 31st 2000 will be considered for renewing the eligibility criteria for subsequent years. The eligibility criteria would be renewed with reference to the latest available audited balance sheet for the previous year. So the balance sheet, audited balance sheet for the year ended March 31st will be considered, and for the subsequent years the eligibility criteria would be the latest available audited balance sheet. And next note is banks which make investment under paragraph 5 means under guideline number 5 of the above guidelines and later qualify for risk participation in insurance business will be eligible to apply to the Reserve Bank for permission to undertake insurance business on a risk participation basis. So those banks which are not eligible currently to take part into insurance business through the joint venture or risk participation criteria, if these banks later on fulfill the criteria, then these banks can apply freshly to the Reserve Bank of India for the permission to undertake insurance business on risk participation basis. And now these are the guidelines, but what happen if the guidelines not followed by the bank? Then the penal action for violation of guidelines. So violation of the above instructions, rules, guidelines will be viewed seriously and will invite deterrent penal action against the banks. So Reserve Bank of India also saying that the Reserve Bank of India will take the serious action if penal action, if violation of the above instructions will be if banks do not follow the instructions or guidelines, then the bank will invite deterrent penal action against the bank. So friends, I hope you understood something, and if you have any problem or any clarifications or any doubt, then you can write me. You have to write the name in the comment box, and if you have any doubt, then you can write to me. Thanks for watching. See you in the next lecture.